So we are discussing from Bhagavad Gita chapter 3. Okay, and we discussed till the text number 2, question of Arjuna. Okay, so Arjuna was confused that which one should follow, to fight or not to fight, to use your buddhi yoga and avoid these abominable activities like fighting, and or the second one is to fight, because Krishna is saying you use your buddhi and avoid abominable activities, and then Krishna is saying you fight. So both are like contradictory. So Arjuna is confused here. The shloka onwards, Lord Krishna is answering Arjuna's question. So from 3rd to 9th, this is called Niskam Karm Yoga. Okay, that is the second section of this chapter. Okay, so let us in this section Krishna Krishna begins answering the Arjuna question by pointing out the defect in his desire to renounce the duty. So the idea which Arjuna took is different, so Krishna will correct him. Okay, first thing he will correct there. So third shloka. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Loke Asmin Dvividha Nishtha Pura Prokta Mayanagha ज्ञान योगेन सांख्यानाम कर्म योगेन योगिनाम. द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड इट सेड, ओ सिनलेस अर्जुन, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन दैट देर आर टू क्लासेस ऑफ मैन हु ट्राई टू रियलाइज द सेल्फ. सम आर इंक्लाइंड टू अंडरस्टैंड इट और बाई सम आर इंक्लाइंड टू अंडरस्टैंड इट बाई इम्पेरिकल फिलोसफिकल स्पेकुलेशन एंड अदर्स बाई डिवोशनल सर्विस. So in the second chapter, verse 39, the Lord explained two kinds of procedures, namely Sankhya Yoga and Karma Yoga or Buddhi Yoga. In this verse, the Lord explains the same more clearly. Sankhya Yoga, or the analytical study of the nature of spirit and matter, is the subject matter for persons who are inclined to speculate and understand things by experimental knowledge and philosophy. The other class of man work in Krishna consciousness, as it is explained in the 61st verse of the second chapter. The Lord has explained also in the 39th verse that by working by the principles of Buddhi Yoga or Krishna consciousness, one can be relieved from the bonds of action, and furthermore there is no flaw in the process. The same principle is more clearly explained in the 61st verse, that this Buddhi Yoga is to depend entirely on the Supreme, or more specifically on Krishna, and in this way all the senses can be brought under control very easily. Therefore, both the yogas are interdependent as religion and philosophy. So, very important thing Prabhupada said here, religion without philosophy is sentiment or sometimes fanaticism, while philosophy without religion is mental speculation. Yesterday we explained on this also. So the ultimate goal is Krishna, because the philosophers who are also sincerely searching after the absolute truth come in the end to Krishna. So this is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. The whole process is to understand the real position of the self in relation to the super self. The indirect process is philosophical speculation, by which gradually one may come to the point of Krishna consciousness. One is direct process, one is indirect process. And the other process is directly connecting everything with Krishna and Krishna consciousness. Of these two, the path of Krishna consciousness is better, because it does not depend on purifying the senses by a philosophical process. So Krishna consciousness is itself the purifying process, and by the direct method of devotional service, it is simultaneously easy and sublime. So there are certain classes of men. Prabhupada is saying in one of his lecture that there are people like different types of people who simply have so much philosophies, and there are certain classes of men who simply blindly follow. Some people will have so much philosophy, they don't know, they will have so many philosophy, and some people will do so many rituals, blindly they will follow but they will not understand the philosophy. So you should be, Prabhupada ji is saying, you should be religious, but you should also understand everything philosophically. This is important. Many people do so many things, but they don't know what is the philosophy. Why you have to offer bhoga? Why you have to do pranam like this? Why you have to do this? Why you have to do that? They don't know. So you have to understand the philosophy. Why Vishnu? Why Krishna? Why Ram? Why Buddha? Why so many God? Why devatas? What is the connection between devatas and God? All this. They don't know the philosophy. Otherwise, one becomes a religious fanatic. Okay, if they don't know philosophy, they become religious fanatic. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is clearly said that Chaitanyera Dayar Katha Karaha Vichar. Karaha Vichar. You people try to understand the gifts of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by your philosophical understanding, not blindly. Not blindly, philosophically, and vichar karile chitte paive chamatkar. If you are actually a wise man, then you will find it is sublime. You think properly, understand Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message, and once you understand, it will be in the heart, it will be great chamatkar. And if you simply stick to your own religious, ritualistic principles without trying to understand the philosophy of everything, then you will become a fanatic. So we should not become religious fanatics. Prabhupada is saying we should not become religious fanatics, nor dry mental speculator. Both these classes of men are dangerous. They cannot make any advancement. You should be religious and also try to understand each and every line philosophically. We have seen many such philosophical speculators. They simply talk in the meeting and that's all. And if we examine their private character, it is less than ordinary. A person may be a nice speaker, but will that help you in your spiritual realization? No. On the other hand, if you chant Hare Krishna, it will give you immediate results. Okay. So many people, they don't understand the philosophy, but they keep on doing so many things. Religious fanatics means they will say, oh, Hindu, oh, Muslim, oh. They will put so much show of their religion. They will fight for the religion. Many people, they are fighting for Hindu dharma, but they don't know Bhagavad Gita. They never read Bhagavad Gita. And many don't even have Bhagavad Gita. Forget about reading. So that's the thing here. Okay. So Prabhupada said we should not become religious fanatics like that. You ask them why it is. You know, many great religious fanatics nowadays, they will be having a big figure in the religious history. They are big men. You go and ask them, who is whose incarnation? Vishnu is incarnation of Krishna, or Krishna is Vishnu's incarnation, or who is big? They don't know philosophy. Okay, so that Prabhupada wanted we should not become like that, religious fanatic. We should understand the philosophy also. And some people, they understand only philosophy, that's another problem. They don't do anything. They know everything, but they did not follow anything. That's another problem. They are called mental speculators. They just know everything, but they don't follow anything. Okay, that's what Prabhupada is saying, what is the use of not being, if you don't follow. Okay, so karma and sankhya both are valid and independent path of self-realization. Action and sankhya yoga 2.39 explained about these two processes. One is called sankhya yoga, which means analytical study, and karma yoga, second process, that is called buddhi yoga, which involves activities or karma. So these are two processes mentioned in 2.39. But the right understanding is that karma stage and jnana stage are two rungs on the same yoga ladder depending on one's nishtha. Nishtha is the word used in text 3.3. It means purity of heart or level of faith. So karma stage is the platform at which work is recommended, and jnana stage is the platform when one is sufficiently purified and deleted to renounce and detached to renounce work. Okay. Okay, so it compares the two parts of Sankhya Yoga and Bhakti Yoga. So Sankhya Yoga defined as the analytical study of the nature of spirit and matter. So everything you analyze, and you say, okay, this no. Finally, you remain so, the spirit, what is it? So, like that. For whom this is the subject matter, for persons who are inclined to speculate and understand things by experimental knowledge and philosophy. So these kind of people should go for Sankhya. But as Prabhupada said in Purport 2.61, it is explained that Buddhi Yoga is to depend entirely on the Supreme Lord Krishna. So that's another method, Buddhi Yoga, Krishna consciousness. By working in Buddhi Yoga, one is relieved from the bondage of work. Both yogas are interdependent as religion and philosophy. Religion without philosophy is sentiment of fanaticism, and philosophy without religion is mental speculation. This is a very famous statement by Srila Prabhupada. Our both the process having same goal, Krishna, and purpose is to establish the real position of the self with the super soul. Our real relationship we have to re-establish, that is the purpose. Okay. So Sankhya Yoga, which is speculation, philosophical speculation, and Buddhi Yoga, which is Krishna consciousness, Bhakti Yoga. So Sankhya Yoga is like indirect path, Buddhi Yoga is direct path. Sankhya Yoga depends on the personal endeavor, what? Endeavor of person who is practitioner. But in Bhakti Yoga, everything depends on the mercy of Krishna. In Sankhya Yoga, or the philosophical speculation, success is not very sure, but in Bhakti Yoga success is absolutely sure. Okay, and very very important thing, that in order to perform philosophical speculation, one's senses should be purified initially. But in Bhakti Yoga it is not required. Anybody can join and start Bhakti, and gradually all the senses will be purified. Okay. So, premature renunciation performed before sufficient purification at the karma stage will neither bring purification nor liberation. Without having fully understanding and getting matured, if somebody takes renunciation, what will happen? 3.4 Na karmana manarambha neskarmya purushosh ashnute na cha sanyasanadeva siddhim samadigachati. Not by merely abstaining from work can one achieve freedom from reaction, nor by renunciation alone can one attain perfection. So the renounce order of life can be accepted when one has been purified by the discharge of the prescribed form of duties which are laid down just to purify the hearts of materialistic men. So without purification, one cannot attain success by abruptly adopting the fourth order of life, sannyas. So without purification, one should not get into that. According to the empirical philosophers, simply by adopting sannyas or retiring from fruitive activities, one at once becomes as good as Narayan. This is what people are saying, Mayavadi. Okay, that once you take sannyas, you become Narayan. But Lord Krishna does not approve this principle. Without purification of heart, sannyas is simply a disturbance to the social order. On the other hand, if someone takes to the transcendental service of the Lord, even without discharging his prescribed duties, whatever he may be able to advance in the cause is accepted by the Lord. That's Buddhi Yoga. That if someone takes to that Bhakti Yoga, service, Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, even without discharging his prescribed duties, whatever he may be able to advance in the call is accepted by the Lord, that is called Buddhi Yoga. Krishna will accept him. Svalpam api yasya dharmasya trayate mahatobhat. Very nice sloka, that even little service done to Krishna is accepted. Okay, so even a slight performance of such a principle enables one to overcome difficulties. So when one is purified by the discharge of prescribed duties, one can surrender. But in the Bhakti Yoga, process starts immediately. Okay. Prabhupada is saying that some of our students went to a well-known Swami here in New York and found that he was smoking. A student said, Swamiji, we don't smoke. And he was ashamed. So what is the use of taking this kind of sannyas? Sannyas means to give up all material contaminated activities for the sake of the Supreme Lord. This is called sannyas. For the service of Krishna, you leave everything. It's not like that you just got frustrated, so you went somewhere. No. For the service of Krishna, you need to... because you want to fully serve Krishna, that's why you have left everything. That is called sannyas. Okay? Okay. So, then, satnyasa. Sannyas means satnyas, means sannyas. So, this is the combination of sat means the supreme, the ever existing, and nyasa means renunciation. So, that means one who has renounced everything for serving the supreme is a real sannyasi. For the service of Krishna, if you are leaving everything, then you are real sannyasi. How he dresses doesn't matter. Anyone who has sacrificed his life for service of the Supreme Lord, he is sannyasi. Prabhupada saying, it doesn't matter what kind of dress a person is wearing. But if a person is dedicated his life for the service of Krishna, then he is called sannyasi. Okay. So now there is a question. Okay, what is that? Okay, so this word may be new for few people, Bhakti Yoga or Buddhi Yoga. So Buddhi Yoga or Bhakti Yoga is same thing but different name. So in this it is said that you just engage yourself. So there are different type of yoga. So there are different type of yoga. Yoga means to connect with the Lord, because the word yoga is from Sanskrit. So the meaning itself is to connect. So connect with the Lord. So yoga, the goal of the yoga is to connect with the Supreme Lord Krishna and re-establish our lost relationship with Krishna. So that is yoga. So there are different yoga, Jnana Yoga, Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, like that, different yoga. So, but Bhakti Yoga is, that's why the comparison between happening Sankhya Yoga and Bhakti Yoga. So Bhakti Yoga is very easy process, anybody can do. You don't need any further, any prior purification, because while in the process of Bhakti Yoga, you will get purified. So you can just come and start doing it. So that's the benefit here. So Bhakti Yoga means basically Shravanam Kirtanam, means you hear about Krishna and you chant about Krishna. You chant Krishna's name and you chant Krishna's stories. You sit and do nicely chanting Hare Krishna, or you do Kirtan somehow, this thing. And hear Krishna Katha, more and more Katha, Krishna's about Krishna, more and more you will hear, then you will be purified. Okay, so that is called Bhakti Yoga, means engaging ourselves in the hearing and chanting of the glories and name fame of Krishna. That is called Bhakti Yoga. Hare Krishna. Okay, so any other question you can ask.